do that quickly and then remind that person. But we are praying, God, show me mercy. Show me mercy in this fasting, this 40 days fasting. Show me mercy. May I not live the same. May I know your purpose. May I be able to fulfill your purpose by your mercy. In the name of Jesus, lift up your voice, pray. Come before the God of the Lord, Le branda balaba banda banda balaba basha da la balaba le kololo brondo bolo boshe kele le balaba rabandi li bandele le be ko brondo ko shaba la balaba la balaba le brondo boshe kada le be in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. I want us, hallelujah. I want us to do something quickly. If the any of the administrators can pin my video so that it doesn't keep changing on the social media platform because it's changing currently. So if you can, first of all, we pin the video, then secondly, we spotlight the video so that it doesn't keep changing among the other participants. So we want to pray. We are not yet there, but we want to pray again and get there. I want us to hit a certain level before we move into other things. We are praying again, God, show me mercy. Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12. He said that we should come and obtain mercy. You want to pray now that God, show me mercy. Show my family mercy. Show my education mercy. Show my relationship mercy. Show my business mercy. Show my spiritual life mercy. Show my Christian work mercy. In the name of Jesus, lift up your voice. Pray. Makabranda balaba shakalabadaba. Mado shikele lebranta balaba shakadala balaba banda baliana. Lebrondo ko shakalabranda balabalaba. Put pressure, pray. Mako shaka branda balaba. Iko shikelele brandian kelele balaba. La branda balaba shaka dalaba banda balabalaba. Le brandia kololo wa shaba. Le brandia shaka balaba. Mako kelele balaba. Show us mercy. Show us mercy, God. In this 40 days of fasting, show us mercy to be able to fulfill your purpose. Show us mercy to fulfill your purpose. You have given us in the mighty name of Jesus. Show us mercy. 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 Le brandi li bi ko chekele le branda ma ko solo lo ko chekele le baba li bondo ko lo branda ba. Ah, pray, somebody. Enter into the throne of heavens. Obtain mercy. For the journey ahead. Obtain mercy. For the purpose of God for your life. Obtain mercy for his counsel. Obtain mercy. Mako shakaya. Ikabra shakata. Leko shikeleleba. Lebrandia kotalalaba shaba. Lekaba shaba. Pray, we are not there yet. Pray, we are not there yet. Climb. Lift up your voice. Build up your most holy faith. Stir up your spirit. Speak in flesh. The Holy Ghost, take the camp of the enemy by storm. Arrest my Messiah. In Canada, so pray, focus, close your eyes, pray, lift up your voice, cry out in the spirit, be aggressive, press. Ask for mercy to fulfill purpose. Ask for mercy to fulfill purpose. Cry out. Cry out. Whether you are watching on Facebook, on listen, let the mercy of God locate you in this 40 days of fasting. Be aggressive. Be aggressive. Pray. Satana Bakatana Matabalaba. Makotokota Pashabalabalaba. Makatana Makate La Paya. Ikoto Shatananamasaya. Ikanamaka Shakatalaba Palabalaba. Ikaprakata Bakatalaba Shabalabalaba. Ikatanabalabala. In the press, cry out, press, in the spirit, press, cry out, oh God, 40 days of seeking you, 40 days. For you, 40 days of trying to tap into your platform for our life. 40 days so messy, so messy, so messy. Ikabra shoka bala la la baya, elakaba kotolo wakasha kala bala bala ba, ekabra kotoko bala bala.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. We are getting there. Hebrews chapter 4, verse 16. If you can send the scripture for those who are following. Hebrews chapter 4, verse 16. The Bible says that, therefore, let us with privilege. I'm reading from the Amplified Version. It says that, therefore, let us with privilege. You understand me? That what we are doing, do it with a privilege. Approach the throne of grace. That is the throne of God's gracious favor. With confidence, as you are doing it as a privilege, do it with confidence, number one. Without fear. And so whenever you are approaching the grace of God, you do not approach with fear. Every spirit of fear that has been tormenting you, that has limited you, I cast it out in the name of Jesus. Every spirit of fear that has limited you, maybe you shall be before the throne of grace, getting something for the next 10 years, but fear limited you. Maybe you were having an encounter and then you were afraid, fear limited you. Let every spirit of fear vanish in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
He said that so that we might receive mercy, that as we are approaching the throne of grace, it is so that we might receive mercy for our failures and find his amazing grace to help in time of need. And so there are two things that are important for every believer. The first person is mercy. The second person is grace. Why? Because in time of need, these people are helpers. Grace is a helper. Mercy is a helper. You are praying, God, show me grace and mercy. Let these helpers be activated in my spiritual work. Let these helpers, wherever they have been throughout the years, as I pray now in this 40 days fasting to seek his purpose, let mercy be available. Let grace be available. Wherever I have lacked these two helpers, may they appear. Wherever I will go, may these two helpers appear on the scene. You are praying now that God, show me grace, show me mercy in the mighty name of Jesus. Lift up your voice. Pray, cry out, press. Makatana mahashalom alaba. That we should obtain mercy. I pray, oh God, this 40 days, we want to get the sound of our voices. Let mercy and grace be coming to the throne of grace, of anticipating mercy and grace for the time of need, that there will be helpers unto us. I pray, oh God, as we are set up for your purpose, let mercy be available, let grace be available. In the mighty name of Jesus, pray, cry out, put pressure, lift up your voice, pray, shakatana makolo wahasha, lebrakata lakapia. And let everything distract you in this hour of prayer. Pray, God, let the helpers be activated. Ah, Christ is a helper. Mercy is a helper. In the mighty name of Jesus, we give you the praise, we give you the glory. Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We want to pray. We are lifting up this prayer again for grace and mercy. Whenever you are coming before God, these two helpers must be there. You see, and so a lot of us want destiny helpers. You want all kinds of helpers. But in this scripture, what we are learning is that number one, you need a helper called mercy. It is mercy. It is by the Lord's mercy we are not prevailed. Every spiritual encounter is at mercy. The second thing that you need is grace. You need grace for the spiritual world. You are praying against God. I need these two helpers. He said that for them to help in the time of need. You are praying that God, these two helpers, grace, mercy, may I encounter them. As I pray now, I activate them in my life, in my ministry. In the mighty name of Jesus, lift up your voice, pray. Wherever you are hearing before, press, pray. Grace and mercy be activated in our life. This 40 days of fasting and prayer, I activate this help, grace. Presence of God, may grace and mercy appear in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray, oh God, we command the help of the throne room in the mighty name of Jesus. Makato kona brash kapaya, ikapana mashataya, lebrante keteke shapa, ikatona masaya, lekani matonaya, elebadi akana malabaya, elakona mahashapaya paya, ikete la
para.
In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. I want to pray. I just heard in my spirit, the Lord was saying that whenever we come to the presence of God, there are two personalities that must be there. And that's what we've talked about now, grace and mercy. Listen, everyone is a product of these two things. If you lack these two things, a lot of things will be difficult. You are praying one more time. That's what God said. I heard it clearly. He said that anytime we come before his throne, two things must be there. Two personalities must be there, grace and mercy. I prophesy over your life. Wherever you will go, may these two personalities be there. I decree and I declare over your life. Wherever you will step, wherever you will minister, wherever you will go, may these two personalities be evident, grace and mercy. I pray for your spiritual work. May grace be evident. May mercy be evident in the name of Jesus. That people think you don't deserve that purpose of God, that people think that you do not deserve it, by the power of grace and mercy, may it be released unto you. May you enjoy the fullness of grace. May you also enjoy the fullness of mercy. I prophesy over your life. Enjoy grace. Enjoy mercy. Enjoy grace, enjoy mercy, enjoy grace, enjoy mercy in the mighty name of Jesus. Who am I prophesying to? Release the ministry of grace and mercy. I release the ministry of grace and mercy. After these 40 days, you cannot be the same. Why? Because the spirit of grace and mercy is upon you. The things that you do not deserve, by grace, receive it. The mantle you do not deserve, by grace, receive it. The favor you do not deserve, by grace, receive it. Anywhere you have lacked grace, I prophesy grace. Anywhere you have lacked grace, I release grace over your life. In the name of Jesus, I send grace and mercy into that hospital, into your family, into that situation you have been asking for. In the mighty name of Jesus, I release grace. 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 What is strange grace? What is strange mercy? What is strange grace? What is strange mercy? In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I had a testimony from Pastor Iadeboye. And the testimony was it was like they were saying that people were expecting him. There was a big program. People were expecting him to pray all kinds of prayers. And then one person was able to get close to him. And then when he was listening to him, all he was asking for is God, mercy. Mercy is important. Everybody needs mercy. Everybody needs grace. We are taking our second prayer point, Matthew chapter 16, verse 17. Matthew chapter 16, verse 17. If you can send it in the comment section, that would be powerful. Matthew chapter 16, verse 17. We are in this 40 days to discover his purpose. We are not discovering our purpose. We are discovering his purpose for our life. And so as you are praying and you are fasting, may his purpose be communicated unto you. May you not leave this fasting without his testimony. In the mighty name of Jesus. Matthew chapter 16, verse 17. Then Jesus answered him, "Blessed, happy, spiritually secure, favored by God are you, Simon Bar-Jonah, because flesh and blood has not revealed this unto you, but my Father who is in heaven." And so before the purpose of God, there must be a revelation. Before his purpose, there must be a revelation. You cannot know the purpose of God without revelation. That is why we are having this 40 days of prayer and fasting. So as you are joined, you are not wasting your time. I can tell you that. You are not wasting your time. He said, Simon Bar-Jonah, you are blessed. Why are you blessed? Because flesh and blood has not revealed this to you. Before we go to the revelation of God, see, Jesus makes something very astonishing that we must pay attention to. He said that flesh and blood has not revealed this unto you. And so there are things in this earth that flesh and blood must reveal it to you. Hear me? That is why if you take people for granted, you might cut your own destiny short. That is why when you take people for granted, you might cut your own purpose short. Because Jesus makes us understand that there are certain things That flesh and blood must reveal it to you. There are certain businesses, that flesh and blood must reveal it to you. There are certain ideas, that flesh and blood must reveal it to you. There are certain encounters, that man must reveal it to you. In this 20 days of prayer and fasting, may the counsel of God be revealed unto you. And so he said that Simon Bar-Jonah, and we must understand that the name Simon means to hear. The name Simon means to hear. And so when Jesus was speaking to him, before he would change his name to Peter the Rock, he called him Simon, meaning that your name means to hear. So listen, that flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father which is in heaven. And so God is ready to reveal to those who hear. God is ready to reveal only to those. There is no point, I'm speaking to you prophetically, there is no reason for God to tell you something that you will not hear and obey. And so God, whenever he's revealing his purpose to his people, he must first activate their hearing. And so we are praying that God, first before we ask for his counsel and his purpose, you are praying that God, activate my hearing. Let my senses be activated. Anything that stopped me from hearing you clearly, as I fast in these 40 days, may your counsel be communicated, because my senses are sharpened, my ears are sharpened. You want to pray now in the name of Jesus. God, may I hear clearly in my dreams when I read the Bible, as I am praying now. May your counsel be clear. May my spiritual ears be activated. I am like Simon. I will hear the counsel of God. Lift up your voice. Pray. Every prayer time, I will hear the voice of God.
Thank you. Amen.
So like I said, that the name Simon means to hear. That whenever God is about to show his counsel, the first thing he must do is that he must make sure he has activated the hearing ability of man. One of the fastest ways to hear God, I have said it time and time again, that you must learn to quiet your spirit. That is why prayer is important. That is why worship is important. That is why the study of the word is important. Whenever you will hear God, maybe it was not in the scripture, but I'm here to teach you prophetically that whenever you must hear God, you must learn to quiet your spirit. A lot of noise is the reason why people do not hear God. A lot of TV, a lot of information, a lot of entertainment is the reason why people do not hear God. But today, by the power of the prophetic, may you begin to hear God expressly. May the spirit of God evidently, may you not struggle again. Anytime the Holy Spirit will speak, pick it up. In the name of Jesus, I pray for you. I declare that in your life, may you hear God from your stomach, from your belly, from your spirit. May you hear God. May there be a vibration in you. Whenever God speaks to you, let there be a vibration in your belly. I prophesy over your life. By the ministry of the Holy Spirit, let the power of the heavens come over you. And from today, let there be a vibration in your belly. I hear God say that there are some people that they'll begin to feel a vibration in their spirit. That is a sign for them to know that I am talking to them. Who am I prophesying to? Anytime there is a vibration, I came to give you encouragement. I came to give you enlightenment. The Lord God is saying that whenever he's speaking to you, there shall be a vibration in your spirit, and you will know that that is the counsel of God. When I was growing up in the prophetic, one of the ways that I would know that God is speaking to me is that there will always be a sharp sensation in my heart, and I will know that God is speaking to me. I prophesy over your life. May you hear God. May you hear God. May you hear God. In Jesus' name. Jesus, we are praying now. God, he said that flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father who is in heaven, you are praying now. My Father, what is your counsel for me? What is your purpose for me? Listen, we have only 50 days to end the year. We have only 50 days to end the year 2020. And 50 is a prophetic number that is embedded in grace. We are praying that God, we are praying for grace already. And so we are praying that God, by grace and our hearing ability, as we are ending this year with 50 days, what is your counsel for me? What is your purpose for the next year? What is your purpose even as we are ending the year? You are praying and you are crying out. You are praying earnestly, God, what is your counsel? Like it was recorded about Simon, that God revealed who Jesus was to him. You are praying for yourself, God, let there be a revelation as I pray now. Let there be a revelation as I cry out now. Let the counsel Hallelujah. Want to take a prayer point again, as I was praying, the Lord said, stop the prayer and look at what I am showing you. And I saw in the realm of the spirit, it's like somebody you entered into a business, or you're trying to enter into a business. Wait. The business is in the area of phone. Something like you wanted to do business of phone and or something. You are about either you have started, because I can see that you have maybe bought a few, one or two or three or something. Something that you are about to start. But God is asking me to tell you that don't enter into that business. It's not everything that God approves. All right? It's not everything that God approves. But I heard God clearly say that there's somebody who's about to enter into that thing. Stop it. Don't enter into that business. If you are the person, I came as a voice to warn you and to correct you that that's not what God is asking you to do. So whatever it is that you have planned, whatever money you are trying to invest in that, stop it. God will show you. This person is not a guy. This person is a lady. This person is a lady. Stop it. You lose money. You want to pray. I want to take this prayer point again. Now, God, show me your counsel. May I not enter into any wrong business. Those of you who followed me to minister the last time at my lecturer's fellowship or ministry, you remember that there was this lady who, there was a prophetic word about a lady who, you know, she lost a son, and how God revealed what had happened to her and what God was trying to plan for her life. Listen, the prophetic is something that God has established for the help of his people. And the prophetic is on the foundation of hearing. And so whenever the people of God are not hearing, anytime that thing happens, they go into error. You are praying again, God, show me your counsel. That thing I am entering, show me your counsel. You want to pray, God, I will not make any wrong move again. There is no time. I've been saying it time, no day. There is no time. Listen, now in this dispensation, your error can take you 5 years to correct. Your error can take you 10 years to correct. Listen to me. Your error can take you 20 years to correct. Your error can take you a lifetime to correct. There is no time to make mistakes in this dispensation. Time, no day. There is no time. You are praying, God, may I not make a mistake again. As I'm speaking, you are remembering the mistakes that you made that has caused you so much of wastage, delay. But you are praying that, God, from today, may I hear, may I not make any mistake. Lift up your voice. Pray. God, may I hear you. Sending that thing, may I hear you.
Shaka tama tuna I pray in the mighty name of Jesus that I'll be connected. I'll be connected to here. I will forever be connected to here. That I will forever be connected to here. I pray in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah. Want to pray? John said that a man can receive nothing. You are talking about receiving. A man can receive nothing until it be given to him from above. Want to pray? If you are texting me about any prophetic word, just hold on. We will deal with it. I want us to pray now seriously. If you will receive anything, like we read from the story of Peter, it must be given to you by God. But what we are learning from this scripture, that a man can receive nothing, the word received there is the word lambano. And so a lot of times people think that when we are receiving, you just wait and then it comes to you. I want to correct that error. That when John said that a man can receive anything from God except it be given to him, that word receive is the word lambano, which means to stretch and take it. And so in the prayer guide, you might get a revelation. You might get an instruction. Your assignment is to stretch and take that thing that God has given to you. If you sit down, someone else will pick it. I'm speaking to you as a prophet. If you sit down, anyone who is aggressive than you will pick it up. And so when God said, or when the Bible said that a man can receive nothing except it be given to him by God, what he's saying that a man can take nothing. If God has provided healing for you, except you take it, it is not yours.
Mm.
If God has given you a ministry, except you take it, it is not yours. If God has given you a powerful prophetic ministry, except you take it, it is not yours. If God has given you a powerful marriage, except you take it, it is not yours. Who am I speaking to? Can you type, I take it, I take it. Whatever God has given to you,
take it.
Whatever God will show you in this 40 days of fasting, you are praying that God, I receive it and I take it. Whatever God will reveal to you, any business, any idea, any mantle, any prophecy, any spiritual gifting, I take it. You are praying that God, whatever you show me in this 40 days, I stretch and I take it. Can you lift up your voice? Pray, God,
I take it.
In the name of Jesus. Second Corinthians 3, verses 2 and 3. My assignment is also to help you understand the purpose of God, his purpose. 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verses 2 and 3. The Bible says that you are a letter of recommendation. Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
I'm telling you that his purpose for you. Okay, so because they posted the King James Version, let me read the King James Version. He says that ye are our epistle written in our hearts. So you are an epistle. Do you know that the first place to get what God's purpose is about you is in the scriptures? That is why if you're a believer, you don't read your scriptures, you're in trouble. You will not know about yourself. Because other people will tell you who you are. You will not know what God is saying about you if you don't read your scriptures. That's why in the guide, there are scriptures that's supposed to back every prayer point. And the apostle is saying that you are an epistle. So I want to take that. What is an epistle? It is a letter adapted in the books that are sacred. That's what I said in the beginning. I said that it is a recommendation letter. So you are a recommendation letter. That is who you are. What do we do to letters? If you know, you can type it. What do we do to letters? If you are given a letter, what will you do to it?
Read it.
Fantastic. So, verse 2 says that ye are our epistles written in our hearts, known and read of all men. So you, what God is telling you is that you are a letter that people are reading. That is why you must be careful the way you behave and the things you say. Because you are an epistle that is sacred. You are a letter that the world is reading. A lot of things that happen in the body of Christ, whether good or bad, this is the solution. So if you are living a bad life outside, what is happening is that as a believer, that is why there are some people that have caused a lot of people to backslide because they did not know that they were letters that people are reading. So you can be a pastor and you kill your wife. You can be a pastor and then you speak anyhow. You can be a pastor, you conduct yourself anyhow. What is happening is that people are reading you. You are an epistle. So if you call for sons and daughters, do this, do that, and you are disobedient. You are an epistle that people are reading. Maybe you think that nobody saw it, but what I'm telling you that people are reading you. He said that that are known and read of all men. Now the word then known is the word ginosko, which you see, whenever they use the word known, it means that there is a fellowship that happens so much that you become like that thing that you are fellowshipping with. So somebody can encounter you as a believer because you're an epistle and know you to the point that the person can become like you. That is why we are able to raise sons and daughters, because people can know you so much that they become like you. That's why Paul said, follow me as I follow Christ. That as I am, so are you. That is the scripture. You are an epistle.
Amen.
And we are read of all men. You are read of all men. Verse 3. For as much as ye are manifestly declared to be the epistle of Christ. Number 2. You are not just an epistle, but you are an epistle of Christ. Ministered by us. Written not with ink, but with the spirit of the living God. With the spirit of the living God. And so you are an epistle that was written by the spirit of God. The thing that you are doing in your life, is it the spirit of God that wrote it? His purpose. The thing that is happening in your life. That is why when you read the scripture and you check yourself, instead of God, this thing happening in my life was not written about me. I cancel it. That is when you enter into prayer. And in verse 4, he talks about this is the confidence that we enter into these things. And that is for us as fathers. So we don't want to go there. But number 1, you are an epistle that is written by the Holy Ghost. You are an epistle of Christ. Whatever you do is being read by men. It's not only being read by men, but it has the power for men to know you and become what you are. Are you making impact in the classroom? Are you making impact in that business suit? Are you making impact in that family? What have people read about you? What have people read about you? What have people read about you? The counsel of God. The counsel of God. So 2 things. Number 1, we are known by what we do. Number 2, we are read. People are reading us. Hallelujah. So when the Bible says that we are being known and we are being read, what it means is also to know accurately. You see, what the power in reading is different from hearing. Whenever we are hearing, there is always a tendency to miss a lot of the things that we are able to retain because of the way that we are trained or the way that we try and memorize things. But when it comes to reading, the word there is also a root word from the same ginosko. And so it's also like knowing. But what it is saying is that it is to know accurately. When the Bible says that people are not only knowing you, but they are reading you, what the Bible is saying that people know accurately by you as an epistle. If people have to know the love of God, what I am telling you is that for people to know it accurately, it is because of you. It's because of you. If we say that people are supposed to be prayerful and you are an epistle, they are supposed to know because of you. You are praying, God, everything you have purposed for me, let it manifest. May I walk in it. Anything that is your counsel about me, may I walk in it. I am an epistle. On social media, I am an epistle. In my family, I am an epistle. In that classroom, I am an epistle. Lift up your voice, pray. I am an epistle. I am an epistle. I am an epistle. We have 5 minutes to pray. Lift up your voice. I am an epistle. I am an epistle. You are an epistle that is written by the Spirit. We are epistles. We are written epistles. Alabahaya. Makotian pelele bokosha. Makanala bakashi kalabala bakasha. Ele balu akani ahes de telebalaba. Rabosha kalalaba shabalaba. You are an epistle. You are holy epistle. You are written epistles written by the Spirit of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Listen, you are a written epistle. You are a written epistle. People will see you and begin to pray. They will not know why. Because you
Amen.
Are, see,
Amen.
You know how to say what you are. You are a written epistle. People will see you praying and the spirit of prayer will fall upon them. People will see you prophesy and the spirit of prophecy will come upon them. This is who we are in the kingdom. People will see you heal the sick and that same spirit will be transferred upon them. People will see you show love and that spirit of love will transfer upon them because of what you are an epistle. You are a living epistle. You are not dead. You are a living epistle. Listen, by a life of testimony, you are a living epistle. Don't live this 40 days fasting, living like a normal person. You are a living epistle. You are a holy epistle. You are a letter of recommendation. Somebody wants to recommend prayer to somebody. It is you that they will pick and say, this is the letter of recommendation. This is the epistle for prayer. Somebody will pick Paula, will pick Tony, will pick anyone, Adolphus, and say that this is the epistle of prayer. Somebody will pick Matilda and say, this is the epistle of holiness. Somebody will Amen. Pick Azalia and say, this is the epistle of prophecy. You are an epistle. You are a letter of recommendation. Don't look down on yourself. You are. This is what God is saying about you. If somebody wants to recommend someone for healing, you are the person we are looking at. They are looking for a recommendation on miracle. You are, may you be that person they are looking at. May you be that person. Listen, those 40 days, you cannot be the same. You cannot.
Amen.
By the spirit of prayer, you cannot. By the apostolic and the prophetic mandate on this ministry, you cannot. You cannot. You are an epistle. You are an epistle. You are an epistle. Somebody wants to look at financial breakthrough. They say that this is the epistle for financial breakthrough. Apostle Tony.
Amen.
This is the epistle for healing. This is Fungatila. She is the epistle for kingdom prosperity. Kalua Hashaya.
Amen.
You are an epistle. You are an epistle.
Amen.
You are an epistle. I'm hearing God. He said he's recoding people's DNA. He's recoding. He said, anyone on this platform, shall I receive it?
I receive it.
He's recording things in your spirit. You are that epistle. They are looking for the miraculous. And then they will pick Rhoda, they will pick Paul, they will pick Tony, that this is the epistle from the miraculous.
I receive it.
You are an epistle. I don't want to take too much of your time. we are lifting up our final prayer. God, make me a testimony. Make me a testimony. Make me an epistle to this generation. Make me a letter of recommendation to my family, to my business, to my classroom, to my school. Make me. Lift up your voice. Pray. Ah, Badua Kaba. I am the epistle for healing. I am the epistle for prayer. I am an epistle for the prophetic. I am an epistle for kingdom
Hallelujah.
Listen, because of time, we have to close now. We'll continue tomorrow. All right, we'll continue tomorrow. If you have not shared it, I want to encourage you. Go on Facebook, go on Instagram, and share Charis Embassy. Share the post. Be a blessing to someone. Let this post also be an epistle to someone. Let it be a letter of recommendation to someone. Don't be shy. Don't be intimidated. Go on social media. If you're on WhatsApp, you want to share the post, you want to encourage people to register. We are doing serious prayers, and we want to trust God that you will be the reason why someone will be blessed. Hallelujah. Okay. And so tomorrow, same time, 9:30, we start. As soon as you join, we are lifting up prayer. We are firing prayer. Tomorrow is another powerful time. You don't want to miss it. And so those who were trying to text me privately, I'll get back to you, and then we will pray. Is that okay? And so make sure that you are in tune. As you leave here, you go. I'm not letting you go to just go and do other things. Stay in the spirit. Paul said that if you say that you live in the spirit, then walk in the spirit. Somebody say walk in the spirit. He said that if you say that you live in the spirit, if you say that you live in the spirit, then walk in the spirit. That was the recommendation of Paul. If you say that you live in the spirit, you are a spiritual being, then walk in the spirit. And so as we are letting you go, I'm not just letting you go to go and do all kinds of things. Stay in touch. Stay in tune. Get a worship song. Listen to. Get the prayer points are for you to continue praying. They're for you to continue feasting with the Holy Spirit. Is that okay? And so I don't know if Apostle has anything. If not, I'll just pray for you and then dispatch you so that we meet tomorrow. Yes, walk in the spirit. Yes, God bless you. So those on Facebook, God bless you also for joining. If you're on Facebook, we want to recognize your presence. Thank you so much for joining. And see you tomorrow. Share the post. If you're on Facebook, watching on Facebook, make sure you share the post. Make sure you invite someone tomorrow. Tomorrow will be another powerful session. It will be brutal. Hallelujah. All right, so I'll pray for you and then I describe. Father, I pray for this one. Bless them. Bless them. Let nations call them blessed.
Amen.
Increase them like the Israelites, that the more they were persecuted, the more they increased. Any persecution, may it be reason for their increase. Bless them. Increase them. Prosper them. in the mighty name of Jesus. Every demonic orchestration against their life is canceled. It's canceled. Amen. It's canceled in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. Amen. I love you. Stay spiritual. See you tomorrow. Share the post. Bye-bye.
Bye.